Alright, this is my first time fighting Skarner top, so we'll see how it goes. Yeah, if you want to dive, sure. I think it's worth. It's not bad. Did she auto the tower? Or did the tower just deal that much damage for her? Just E on top of people. I'm like so used to Jarvan W, but the range on that feels so long to me. On the little slam down thing W he has. Yeah, like, it seems so long for like long range to me. It up. Let's see. I'm gonna go in here. Or I could shove and go down mid. My Fury was at like 95. I can't get too close because he'll just R me. Kind of awkward. He doesn't have much mana. That cost 50 mana, what he just did. Not bad. That's actually really good. Cool. Yeah, only reason I went in there so cocky is because he had no mana. And he has no TP. Because of the dive we did earlier.
Oh,
so bad. I don't think I can shove. That's enough. I'm just gonna leave, see ya. Alright. Set up a tunnel here. I'm cool with fighting here. Just don't want to fight too close to his tower. That's all I'm really worried about right now. I did not think about that. The plate, though. Got my ass. Shove. I want to get that plate. Super, super low. What is that? It's the perma slows. Is it who here? Yeah, just play safe for a second. Heal up a bit. I mean, I have Sunfire. I feel like that does magic damage. His Q and his W. I don't know, maybe it does AD. Doesn't he build AD? He has better AD ratios than he does AP ratios. I know that. So would that make sense that he would do physical damage? I don't know. Ah, there it is. The question is, do I fight him? Do I keep fighting him for the opportunity to kill? Or do I stop because he can keep rocking Hearthstone? I'm mid here. Nice, okay, good job. I can't move. Damn. No way. The Annie flash shield. Oh, I'm weak side, I guess. That's crazy. Yeah, I messed that up, but she saved my ass, man. Oh yeah, good job, team. Oh, the trailblazer slow. Oh no. Oh no. The tunnel I blazed made the I hit the limit on that tunnel. So as soon as I placed that, it popped. That's depressing. Alright, let's see what he did. Yeah. Okay, so his passive is magic. His W is magic. Okay. He's like semi-mixed. It's alright though. Let's go. He's getting semi decent art steel stacks. I mean, we have so much. We have Callista and Kindred. Like, I don't think it's really gonna matter. We're just gonna shred him. Eventually. Dang, this guy hurts. Alright. Do shabby. He knows my team's topside. It's just like two unmovable objects running at each other. Oh. What did he buy? Get it. Also, why not TP bot? Rex money. Oh my. Okay, that makes sense. So if he starts charging it close to you, you can cancel it. But if he's like fully ramped up, you can't stop him. See? Big side for real. This guy's not happy. He's gonna talk about how he's weak sided again. I bet. And I was cool just chilling out in this lane, but my support jungler want to go above and beyond, so you know what? I'll take it. Can we react? Happy to. That's cool, I guess. Just gliding across the map. Shouldn't have gone when she was already caught. Damn, she hurts. Yeah, he can just afford to go still first, can't he? He has so much AP, HP scaling. His kit. Like, he has abilities that's their damage scale with HP. So, Rek'Sai can't do that, obviously. Because only passive does that. I'll just hover here. I wish the bank died, but it's alright. Got to the recon E, it's pretty cool. Send it, I don't care. Jeez, let's go.